First thing each day, before anything happens, I take a large key and step out to the coop to wind up the chickens. Properly wound, they'll strut about the yard on their brisk little legs till nightfall, producing identical eggs and the same guttural sound. A fiercely belligerent stance towards you and me is what makes them different. Each being its own weapon, a sort of flower catapult. And a dead shot on top of that is what makes them difficult. Seen lonely poets dashing o'er vales and hills with their anxious expressions, avoiding the diffodils. People who climb mountains are certainly brave. The hazards include blizzards, ungrippable ice, high winds, precarious ledges over sheer drops, falling rocks, and air too thin to breathe. Serious dangers, for which a minute or two at the summit with a big view would seem a poor reward. In most respects, fountains are a lot safer. It's never far to fall, and no one minds a bit of wet. But think how much more clever you have to be to find the right footholds in all those gushing, unstoppable gallons. And then balance and bob at the top like a shooting gallery ping-pong ball. As I sat in his chair and his razor went whir, and his scissors jabbered around my ears, I saw in the mirror how snippings of my hair fell to the floor in a tufty shower. A hirsute downpour landing there, joined with the hair and the wisps of beard that had been cut earlier, to make an ever swirlier flood of fur, all textures and colors, that somewhat to my terror rose higher and higher, till at last I heard the barber murmur, "Will that be all, sir?" And the hair on the floor appeared to gather itself together with a mighty shudder before, I swear, leaping in the air in the shape of a bear that marched to the door and, with a roar, sludged off. Who knows where? Sweetness, bright color, and wobble, the three ingredients of any decent jelly, are known as the Jelliments. As Sherlock Holmes remarked when inspecting sticky spots on a once clean party frock, "Jellimentary, my dear Watson." So, but I just don't know. Some grand and gorgeous birds emit the feeblest squeaks. While others, too drab for words, from their unpromising beaks pour out entire operas. The lyrebird, however, that most voluble of whoppers, displays in every feather that he's a total con. With his taxidermic stance and his tail that looks pinned on,
You know his game at a glance.
It's a very rare specimen, so folk come from far and wide to admire it in my garden, where I don't mind acting as guide. But I always have to tell them that the rules are strict, and while the noses may smell lovely, they mustn't be picked. The oi oi is a toy with some relation to the yo-yo. So if the yo-yo works by an alternation of downward plunges and upward jerks, it spools the main body of the thing, slithering all the way down its string, then momentarily dithering before a nifty pull returns it whirring to your hand. With the oi oi, the spool or drum plummets up and is tweaked back down while the string looped around your big toe makes sure you don't lose it as it floats away. I understand there are some who enjoy the yo-yo more, but I adore the oi-oi and would choose it any day.
Easily enough at any corner shop. But we all know hot when already lurking in there.
people who say the rabbit has no song are wrong. It has at least one in which it sings about the things, lettuce, etc., that it likes to eat. No mention of meat. This ditty is commonly known as the Ballad of Salad. I listened hard to that battle-scarred old pirate lord as he muttered in his beard, but his voice was slurred from the rum he'd poured down his throat from a battered pewter tankard, and squawks from the gaudy bird on his shoulder interfered with almost every word. So, I must have misheard, and it wasn't until my 33rd voyage around the world that I discovered not a fabulous hoard of treasure stored in a chest and buried, but a box of trash. A poor reward for so much arduous sailing and spade work and general boredom.
Leather, 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 leather
look at. He's like any old umpire. Standing there in his white coat and Panama and a big embrace from lots of other people's jumpers. But should you be given out LBW and not leave the crease at once, a new expression will cross his face that will definitely trouble you. And with a sudden pounce, he'll be on top of you, sinking his teeth in your throat! Doctors put me on a musical diet of bagpipes and foghorns, or relative peace and quiet. They all stop to watch as the strange Yatch puts into harbor. Shrouded and macabre, at the tiller, the grim sailor who must sail alone because he knows no one else with the courage to join him on such a voyage. Nor anyone daft enough to trust a craft so flimsily built. So badly spelt. Zagzig is not the same as a zigzag, only the other way around. That would be a zigzag too, can't you see? You must have learned something from your previous lessons. No, a zagzig is a nocturnal fish-eating bee from the Arctic jungle that lives in a hole in the ground. That should be perfectly obvious from the name.